releasing new merch again? Well, in case you haven't heard, I've joined the Elite Battle League for Season 2 with my own team, the Iowa Incineroar. Check out the link in the description for the all-new Iowa Incineroar merch.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's InfernoMan again, and welcome back to another episode of the Pokemon SoulSilver Randomized Attack Block. If you guys missed in the last episode, it was a week ago, and there's still a lot of people that need to watch the last episode, so if you could pause this episode, watch the last episode, and then come back to that one, that would be perfect. But for those of you that have watched the last episode, might be wondering, it's been a week since an episode went up, so what took so long? Well, this episode was actually supposed to go up on Monday this week, but I put it up on Wednesday because the finale of the Sun and Moon Extreme Randomizer Versus with its release MEB came out on his channel, and I wanted people to watch the finale of that series, so I kind of left Monday open. So that's why it's been a week, but in this episode we're going to be taking on the fourth gym of the game, which is, of course, Morty's gym, the ghost-type gym, but due to randomization, that doesn't matter. So if you guys are excited, make sure to smash the like button, subscribe. We are on the road to 1.5k subs by 2022, so definitely hit the subscribe button. Yeah, socials are down in the description, let's move forward with it. So, just a quick thing to get into, everybody's level 25, and I made the ultimate decision to drop Fufu from the team. I'd rather have a ground type. See, it's kind of complicated. So, when it becomes Dragonite, it'll be flying type. We already have Kaicho right now. I already have two other dragon types on the team. And while Avdol could also be considered for being dropped, I just think it's better to have, you know, two fire types and two dragon types rather than three dragon types and one fire type. You know, you get it? It's just my thought process. I just wanted to add more uniqueness to the team and have more types available to us, so I added Blue Moon to have Water and Ice. I hope you guys understand, but that's basically the change to the team that I made, the first change to the team of the series. Let's just see how well that goes for us, you know. So yeah, let's move forward through the gym. Let's see what Morty's gym has in store for us. Alright, here is the first trainer. Alright, let's see what she has. Servant Josh, sending out a Stantler. Wowza, that's not that great. I got excited for no reason. Well, I guess Stantler's kind of relevant again because it's getting an evolution in BDSP, Legends Arceus, but... is this thing going to have 40 HP? I have a feeling it is. If it has more than 40 HP, then so be it. Okay, I had more than 40. And it put us to sleep, so that ended up not working so great for me. Whoopsie. Okay, well, Kaichu's asleep, that's fine. I'm only gonna speed up because Kaichu's asleep. Okay, yeah, he woke up. With a nice amount of HP. Another Stantler. Wow, this lady's got dupes on her team. Nobody has a fighting type move. Nope, Set has Karate Chop. I forget that. I always forget that. You have Karate Chop, so you're actually useful against normal types. Especially since you're immune to them. So, Karate Chop away, Set. Are we gonna one-shot? Yeah. Okay. I kinda didn't expect it with a Stantler. Definitely wouldn't have expected it with a Tauros, but it is 9 levels lower. Dang, this lady's team is full of normal types. We can just keep Set in. As long as they don't use, like, Bite or Crunch or anything like that, we should be fine. But as far as I know, we're faster and can one-shot them, so... 3 for 3 on normal types, is it just gonna keep on going? That'd be ironic for the ghost-type gym. Nope, she is sending out a C-Dot now. You know what, let's send out Kaicho. I mean, it doesn't matter, it's a C-Dot, it's not like it's a Shiftry. It's the first form of the line. Now you guys might be wondering, wow, your Pokemon are 9 levels higher than the gym Pokemon, like... overlevel a bit much, man? No, because Morty's highest level Pokemon is level 25, which is usually a Gengar, so I want to prepare. We're not at the point of the game yet where everything's fully evolved. That's level 30, but still shouldn't be underprepared, because if his level 30 ends up being like an Arceus or something like that, we're not going to want to regret not leveling up our Pokemon, so... I'm hoping to not level up past 26 on anyone. As I say that, Kaichu is almost level 26. So, yeah, there's the first trainer done. Gotta love how the glitch, because some copies of Heart Gold and Soul Silver do this and some don't, where areas where they're meant to be, like, unlit, like this gym, will just show up as a square of the code for the darkness, and everything else will be lit. It's not supposed to do that. You're supposed to be blind. This is supposed to be a hard gym to get through, but thanks to that glitch, it's easier than it's supposed to be. Alright, Fire Blast on this Vigoroth. Definitely gonna have to put Kaicho to the back of the team, because he's definitely leveling up after this. Level 26. Kaicho, do you learn anything at level 26? Doesn't look like it. Diglett. Alright, well, time to use Blue Moon for the first time. Again, not like we really have to because it's a Diglett, but, you know, I usually go for super effectiveness, so why not? Does this thing... It has Drizzle. Thanks for boosting my Surf, bro. Oh, it's using Dig. That's not gonna do much to Blue Moon, it doesn't matter. I'm kinda surprised we're not faster. Yeah, whatever, it's faster than us. At this point, I would kind of expect a speed tie, but it's really faster than us. Is Dewgong a slow Pokemon? I didn't think so. I usually expect, like, a lot of water-type Pokemon to be fast, unless, you know, they're turtles, of course. But whatever, we beat her. It's not like it's the worst thing in the world. It was a Diglett. Alright. Well, let's put Blue Moon in the front just so we can use it more. Because we just added it to the team. See, these following sprites will literally make, like, any Pokemon look lovable. Like, I'm not really a huge fan of Dewgong, but Dewgong's following sprite actually makes it look kind of adorable. And of course, as soon as I put my water ice type to the front, the first trainer has a freaking water type. So we're gonna switch out to Diavolo. I'm hoping that we can unlock the electric type very, very soon, because that would be, like, a super useful type to have. Also, grass! I thought I unlocked grass earlier in the series, but I forgot that Grodle isn't a ground type, which is our only death so far, because I made a terrible mistake. Alright, Dragon Breath onto the Milotic. That didn't way less than I thought it would. Twister isn't going to do too much from a Milotic. How much is Slash going to do? Slash usually does a lot of damage. Yeah, it wasn't too much. We'll speed through that. How much is Ominous Wound going to do? Are we going to finish it off with an Ominous Wound? Goodbye, pretty long fish. Never mind. At least we're fast. It's using Recover. I hate you. We might have to speed up because, yeah, it's spamming Recover. Okay, now we can finish it off. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is the last trainer before Morty, so I'm definitely going to go back and heal. We don't really have to, but I just, you know, usually before I fight a gym leader, I tend to want to go back and heal. Especially since, you know, it's not like this gym puzzle is the most confusing to maneuver. Okay, looks like there's one more trainer. We'll fight this one last trainer. Because this is definitely the last trainer. And then we'll take on Morty. Not too shabby, not too shabby. Alright. Servant Matt. Sending out a Lugia. Alrighty then. Well, see, it's a good thing we added an ice type to the team. Because Lugia. I mean, I could have switched out to Diavolo and used Ancient Power and Ominous Wind. But, you know, it's nice to have an ice type on the team. So let's Icy Wind this thing. I'm not expecting a one-shot, but a freeze would be nice. No, but we lowered its speed. I don't even know if Icy Wind can freeze. Let me look that. Look at that. I don't know if Icy Wind can actually freeze or not. No, it can't. Can't Ice Shard, though? No, not even Ice Shard can. Interesting. I thought one of our Ice-type moves could freeze. But whatever. Ice is the least chance of effect to actually go in. You know what I'm trying to say. Out of all the other status effects, ice is the least, freezing is the least likely to happen, is what I was trying to say. That is statistically correct. All right, it's using Gust on us, which is literally the weakest flying type move next to Peck. And we're lucky this isn't the gym leader, because if she healed a Lugia, I mean, it's not like it would be the end of the world, based on what moveset it has, but I just didn't want to weaken it again, so goodbye Lugia. That's going to be a heck of a lot of experience. Yep. Blue Moon level 26. Who's next? Onyx! You know, I know we just leveled up to 26, but a Surf is going to knock this thing out. It's quad effective. Let's just do it. I could have Karate Chopped with Set, but we're faster. This thing's going to get knocked out. Unless it has Sturdy, but randomized abilities, yeah. If it had Sturdy, Onyx doesn't normally have Sturdy randomized abilities or not. So I'm pretty sure we'd be fine even if it wasn't randomized. But Togepi in this generation is not Fairy type, because Fairy types don't exist, so let's Karate Chop it in the face. Togepi. Well, bam. One shot the Togepi. Or not. How did a Togepi... Okay, we have Vital Spirit. For the first time, Vital Spirit actually comes into effect. How did we not one shot a Togepi? I'm kind of confused about that. It's a Togepi. That's a level up for Sid as well. Alrighty then. Well, Servant Matt has been defeated. Yes, you did lose. Speaking of Matt, the Matt in the game files is supposed to be Twin Leaf Matt, but it's kind of relevant to this week because by the time you guys are watching this, or the day that it comes out is the day after I recorded my first match of the EBL against Matty Ice, aka Stone Family 64, and his Atlanta Braviary. And I don't want to jinx myself at this point. I just want to say that I hope the match went well for the both of us. I hope it was a good battle for the both of us, no matter the outcome. So, Matt, if you're watching this, whatever the outcome was, GG. I definitely said that in the video, no matter what. But yeah, I'm looking forward to doing that match, because, you know, being a part of the EBL as the weekly roundup co-host with Josh, and watching how the EBL goes down, stuff like that, and growing stronger friendships with all the men in the league. I'm really looking forward to actually being a coach this season. As of last night, I finished my team grinding. So all of my team is competitively trained for the Elite Battle League. So I'm really looking forward to actually having the match. I don't know why I'm all of a sudden messing up this puzzle. It's because the squares are back. I knew it. All right. Moving forward, goodbye. All right, here he is, Rick and Morty. Rick. I believe that Tail Slice secretly trained here my whole life. He's talking about Ho-Oh. He lives here in Ekertik City. And, he's here in Ekertik City because of Ho-Oh. Sorry, I was looking at something there. I lost my train of thought. Strong Man Sparky. Sending out Eradicate. Oh no, not pressure. Okay. I mean, Eradicate should be fairly easy to take down, especially if we get a magnitude 10, right, Abdul? Hyper Fang, shiver me timbers. Magnitude 6 isn't gonna kill it. There's no way 6 is gonna kill it. It did half, though. Not bad. So, a 6 or higher is gonna kill this thing. Alright, yeah, we finished it off. Give me a 6 again. Alright, bye, Eradicate. Alright, who's next? Starly. Okay. Well, obviously, we're gonna switch out to Abdul. I mean, not Abdul, Diavolo. We're gonna switch out from Abdul to Diavolo. I mean, it's just a Starly. It's not like it's a terrifying bird Pokemon, but Ancient Power. Plus, Abdul got 2 Hyper Fangs to Abdul, almost killed it, so. Probably not gonna end up using Abdul for the rest of the battle. Sableye is your next Pokemon. You know, I don't see any reason why we can't just stay in. We'll just hit it with an Ominous one. This one's a level 23, so this would regularly be a Haunter. Okay, so using Detect. Thank you for that, Sableye. Now we're gonna hit with Ominous Wind. It's gonna be neutral because Dark resists Ghost. Astonish isn't gonna do too much. We're faster, so it's not like it can go into effect in flinching us. One more ominous wind to the face, and it is gone. Adios, Sableye. Alright, what's your last Pokemon here? Electrike. Okay, I'm lucky I have Okuyasu because I was literally 2 seconds away from being like, hey, let's just use Abdul again. I mean, I don't know what an Electrike would do to a ground fire type that would absolutely destroy it. It's not like it's going to secretly have Hydro Pump, but this is his Gengar. So, there was nothing really for us to worry about. Yeah, Quick Attack wouldn't kill Abdul, but we're going to use Sand Team. Plus, it left Okuyasu at a nice amount of HP, so is this going to kill? Not close. But hey, at least we trapped it with Sand Tomb, so... is this gonna... No. Okay. We're gonna have to hit it another time. Oh, we missed! Congratulations, Okuyasu, you fricked up. Now I wish I did switch out to Abdul. Is it using a Citrus Berry now? Okay, that didn't do as much as I thought. A Dragon Rage will finish it off. There's no way it has 40 HP plus at this point. It's just gotta finish it off. Dragon Rage isn't too useful at this point, but oh my gosh. Oh, Sand Tomb's gonna finish it off, never mind. I was gonna say, never mind. Oh wait, the HP is so delayed that I thought that like it did 1 HP and still survived, but there we go. How is this possible? I have a full team of very strong Pokemon. I used to have 2 pseudos, I only have 1 now, but I still have a legendary Pokemon who's literally the Satan of your universe, so that is why I received the Fog Badge from Morty. Alright, now we can use Surf outside of battle, so that's nice. Shadow Ball. I wish it was Shadow Ball. Shadow Ball is a really useful TM. Alright, watch this. Every other TM we've gotten from a gym leader, if I recall correctly, has been like super good for what it is, and that usually doesn't happen in randomizers. The one time a really good TM gets randomized, it's gonna be bad. Watch. Wasn't it TM30 he gave us? I mean, Razor Leaf isn't too bad if that's what it was. I mean, I still don't see us having any bad TMs right now besides Magic Coat and Nightmare, so I think he just gave us Razor Leaf. I never look at the numbers, so... we still don't have a Grass type, so it's not like it matters. I'm only gonna teach it to a Grass type. Alright, well, as you guys know, if you watched the last episode especially, we already got our encounter on the next route, because I kind of just wanted to go for it to finish off the episode, and it ended up being a Registeel that exploded on us, which was very ironic, because I recorded that episode, like, shortly before I got the last Shiny Regi, which, by the way, if you guys haven't seen the Shiny Regi reaction compilation that came out on Sunday, the compilation of all my reactions. Also, the Regi Club merch is out now. You guys saw that at the beginning of the last episode. I had a little trailer for you guys, so check out the Inferno merch store. And I talked about the EBL earlier. The Iowan Cinnawar merch is out in the Teespring store too, so check that out down in the description. All right. I think we might be able to go to the right and get an encounter though, but I kind of want to hold that off for when we actually have to go that way, which is when we have to battle Price. And we're supposed to be heading towards Chuck's gym. Technically, we're supposed to be heading towards Jasmine's gym and then battling Chuck because we have to get the medicine. But, you know, if you guys have played Johto games, you know how the story works anyway. A metronome. I literally forget what that item even does. Metronome, where are you? Boosts a move used consecutively. Okay, that actually makes sense what a metronome would do as an item. So if I just spam scratch over and over again, it would boost the attack. That's not a terrible item. I just don't think I'm gonna end up using it on anyone, because I mean, then I'm gonna worry about using the same move over and over again, and then I'm gonna end up making a mistake. That's how my mind works. Okay, we don't have any psychic type moves, I don't think. We had one on Dragonair, if I recall correctly, but... Ah, whatever, let's just move forward. Chuck's ace. What is Chuck's ace? We do have to battle Silver soon, I think. No, he doesn't battle us, he just talks to us about how much of a weakling Jasmine is or something like that, because her Ampharos is sick or something like that. Chuck Pokemon. I want to see what his levels are just so we can prepare ourselves. I mean, there's going to be a bunch of trainers for us to fight, but I just want to make sure, you know, I'm not over leveling. Okay, in the core series,
I want to see Heart Gold and Soul Silver, please. This is for Black 2 and White 2. Heart Gold and Soul Silver, that's not his gym, that's rematches. His Poliwrath is level 31, and he only has two Pokemon, a level 29 and a level 31. Okay, so I think we don't have to battle every single trainer we come across, but if I do have to grind, I have to grind, but we're definitely not battling Chuck in this episode, so I don't have to worry about that. So let's just move forward. I'm going to dodge this trainer, because we don't really have to battle any of the trainers on this route. We're going to have to battle this girl, because she kind of looked at us. But that's okay. That is A-okay. Alright, Servant Sparky sending out a Spirit Tomb. Interesting. Alright, well, let's hit it with a Magnitude. Ooh, hitting it with a 9. Good job, Abdul. One-shotting a Spirit Tomb with Magnitude. Absolutely beautiful. Alright, who is our next victim? Blaziken! Yeah, well, let's just stay in. Let's see how much another Magnitude will do. Very, very nice Blaziken. I actually like Blaziken's Gen 4 sprite a lot. I feel like Gen 3 starters, strangely enough, their sprites peaked in Gen 4. Because I love Sceptile's Gen 4 sprite. And Swampert's is really freaking awesome, too. So, oh, she's got a Moo Moo Milk. Surprising. And that was not sarcastic. Okay, it's using Peck again. Yeah, I just think it's strange. I feel like a lot of starter Pokemon, like, their sprites peak the generation after they're introduced. Because, like, the Gen 1 starters look amazing in the Gen 2 sprites. The Gen 2 starters look pretty cool in their Gen 3 sprites. The Gen 3 starters look good in their Gen 4 sprites. Gen 4 starters look really cool in Gen 5. And then after that, it's 3D models, so, you know, they pretty much look the same afterwards. No, I don't want to get your phone number. You glitched out my game. Alright, let's put Diablo in front. It's been a while since we had our Giratina behind us. Okay, can we stop glitching out the game? Thank you. I appreciate that. Alright. See, I knew there was somebody here, but I just kept on going. And see, he's going to stop us from moving that way anyways, so it was pointless. Alright, Engineer Max. You know, oddly enough, he looks like Max from the Pokemon anime, so that's actually kind of fitting. It's just a Hippopotas. I don't really need to strategize for it. If this Dragon Breath doesn't kill it, we'll just use another Dragon Breath. Almost killed it, though. Oh, it's using Bite. Wow. Didn't do too much because it's a tiny Hippo Pokemon. I'd be more scared if it was a Hippowdon, and if it used Crunch instead of Bite. Alright. But again, even a Crunch from Hippowdon isn't going to be stabbed, so... Yeah. Why is everybody asking me for their phone number? My phone number. I don't want anybody's phone number. Leave me alone, Max. Alright. Cloyster! Oh boy. We could have caught that if it was our encounter. Great, more glitches. Kabutops also could have been caught and unlocked the rock type. Wow. Pretty good encounters that we could have gotten besides an exploding legendary. Alright. Oh, is that Joseph Joestar? Just kidding, it's Mr. Pokemon. No, it's Baoba. I forgot about this character. Oh, what you're holding is what they call a Pokédex. Haven't seen one of those in ages. My name is Baoba. I used to run a Safari Zone in Fuchsia City, but it was becoming out of date with new entertainment options coming out. Oh, no! Oh, wait, I can play that on my soundboard. You guys can actually hear my soundboard. Oh my god! Anyway, I decided to go overseas to learn the newest technology and open a state-of-the-art Safari Zone in Cyanwood. Maybe more than a coincidence that we are chatting. Why don't we register each other's numbers in the Pokégear? Okay, I'm only gonna take this guy's number because he's a main character, like, not a main character, but, like, he's a more important NPC. That makes sense. Plus, we're probably gonna run into the Safari Zone anyway, so. Alright, see you later, my friend. Moving forward. I believe they give you an item over here. I don't know. It's supposed to be Moo Moo Milk, of course. I'm pretty sure. But I don't know if it's randomized. There's an item over here. Is it a Master Ball? No, it's a TM. Okay. Well, it's Acid Armor, which isn't too important. Alright. I wonder if we're going to be able to get an encounter before the end of the episode. Is this another route?
It is another route, and I know there's grass up ahead, so we ran into a trainer. Great. Manectric. See, why couldn't Morty have this? He had to have an Electrike, which was super easy. I did not see what he was sending out. Oh, ourselves. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, he's using Shadow Sneak. A lot of damage for a Shadow Sneak, but, you know, to be expected from a Giratina. But we are the superior Giratina. We're 5 levels higher. Dragon Breath. That looks like a crit. And we're fully paralyzed. Great. I think at this point we should switch out. Should I switch out to Set? Yeah, we'll switch out to Set. Why not? Okay, he's using Shadow Sneak again. Oh, that was a crit. Okay. You'd be able to survive another one. Let's use Nightshade. Oh, it's using Ominous Wind. Oh, no. Thank you, Set. Dusknoir is very tanky, so that's why I used Nightshade, because I didn't expect it to use a different Ghost-type move, but I'm thankful we survived. Okay, I'm switching out to Kaiju and just finishing it off with Dragon Rage. I don't care. That was a close encounter. Well, it's just going to use Shadow Sneak again, which is going to do that much. We'll use Dragon Rage to finish it off. Okay, so yeah, that was pretty scary, but we have a Giratina of our own, so we pretty much weakened it with our own Giratina. But Set was very, very close to dying there. I did not expect an Ominous Wound. And it was Guanaco, of course it was Guanaco. Alright. I know there's another trainer or two ahead, so I'm probably gonna heal just for the sake of catching what's ahead. Because I do want to catch a Pokemon before we end off this episode. And I don't want to kill a Pokemon before we do that, so yeah. Speed it up a little bit more. I just want to use one on Kaicho, one on Abdul, and one on Diablo. There we go. Alright, Heal Powder, because we don't have Paralyzed Heals, which I should definitely buy in the next town. Alright, summaries. Everybody 26 now? No. Okoyasu is 25, okay. Well, let's move forward. Please don't let me run into anyone else. I just want to get my encounter. Sailor Moon, stop looking at me. Sailor Moon. All right, there we go. This is where we can get our encounter. All right. First encounter, actual type we have unlocked. Yes, a Seadra. Okay, it is just pure water type now, but I think there was a town where we could buy a dragon scale. So we could evolve this. But catching this wouldn't unlock the dragon type. Wait, we already have dragon type unlocked. I'm stupid. Why was I thinking that? Yeah, let's throw into a great ball. Why not? Why not? What would we name this, though? What would we name this? I'm trying to think of what would match with seahorses. Well, first of all, I should probably attack it. Because we're probably not going to catch it without attacking it first. We'll tackle it one more time. What JoJo character would we name this after? I'm very happy we have Clear Body. Alright, Great Ball. Great Ball actually matches with the fact that it's water and blue, so it did not stay in the ball, though. Yeah, just keep on using Smokescreen. I appreciate it. Just stay in the Great Ball. You have nowhere else to go, my friend. Game Boy Luke. There we go. That's how we do it. Alright, Seadra was caught. Very good ending to the episode. What are we gonna name this? Who are we gonna name this after in JoJo? Trying to think of, like, more water-type, like, stands, because Blue Moon is, like, the only one that, like, is known for swimming. I'm just really trying to think here, because it's kind of complicated to think of something like this. I can't really name it. You know what? Let's name it Geb. Or Jeb, however you pronounce it. Because that is a water type stand, because Nidhuel literally uses the water to, like, attack people. So we'll just name it Geb, because that's the first thing that I can think of right now. Plus, you know, the horsey line's kind of, you know, known for using water gun. Wade, shut up. I'm not gonna outro my video with the Poke Gear going off. Shut up. Anywho, after that annoying bout, thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Soul Silver. I really, really appreciate it. Again, if you haven't watched the finale for the verses on Timmy's channel, definitely go check that out. That's why this went up on Wednesday. I guess I can make this quick announcement if you guys are still watching at this point. Next week, our next collaboration project with Jeknition and Always More Videos goes up, the three-way Soul Link. I'm uploading on Mondays, Jek's uploading on Tuesdays, and Derek's uploading on Wednesdays. So I'm probably going to end up uploading the series on Thursdays and Fridays starting next week, just so there's no cross-uploading between me and Derek. So yeah. But there's another episode this week, so look forward to that. So yeah, once again, if you guys have not liked the video at this point, please do so. I'd really appreciate that. And make sure to subscribe as well. This is Infernomen burning out, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.